My name is Philip Labonte. I grew up in Western Massachusetts. That's where I spent most of my life. Currently, I live in New Hampshire. Moved out of Massachusetts because of tax law and gun laws. I am a professional musician. I sing for a band called All That Remains. Been doing that as my only job for 20 years or so, 15 years, something like that. The band's been a band for 20 years, and I've played music all my life, or most of my life. I got into firearms because I had a family friend that was always always into guns. He took me shooting when I was a teenager. My father wasn't really he wasn't a hunter. He wasn't really into shooting. He had a 22 rifle that he almost never shot and took out. I joined the Marine Corps when I was 18 years old, and when I graduated Marine Corps boot camp, he gave me an SKS. As a graduation gift. After my time in the Marine Corps, I started really focusing on music, and then once we had once we had reached a certain level of success where hobbies were actually an option again, I was like, I kind of want to start shooting again. So I pulled the SKS out and started looking at the laws in Massachusetts and realized, holy crap, the laws had changed and I needed to go get some paperwork squared away because things that I thought were legal, they weren't legal anymore and had changed without my knowledge because I'd spent the previous almost 10 years focusing on music and being on tour and being away. So I got my permits and stuff all squared away, and then I realized how oppressive the laws in Massachusetts were, and so that was when I decided that I was going to move to New Hampshire. And it was a big portion of it was because, it was, you're not allowed to have this and you're not allowed to do that. And I'm like, this is a free country we live in. I thought that we had a Second Amendment that prevented the government from making laws against this kind of stuff. And it was actually a shock to me. I decided that I wanted to go and go shooting again. All these laws had changed, and that kind of really woke me up to what the government will do behind your back, I guess is kind of a decent way to say it. When I got my FID card in the 90s in Massachusetts, they had said, well, this is going to be good for the rest of your life. It was a simple process, no big deal. And then when I went back to kind of take up the hobby again, they're like, no, all these things have changed. And so I decided that Massachusetts wasn't the place for me anymore. I'm a concealed carry guy. I'm a tool guy. I'm not really a collector. I think that I have what I would consider at least one gun of what you need. You get your shotgun, 22, an AR-15, got handguns that I carry, a bolt gun. But I don't have a bunch of different calibers. Everything is, I've got as few calibers as I can kind of get away with. So for that kind of stuff, having a bunch of calibers and wondering if I've got the right magazine for the right gun and, is it going to fit this time or whatever, I don't get into that kind of aspect of it. I really look at firearms as tools. I don't think that it's enough to just have a gun because there's all these things that are going to be going on if you have to use your gun, and you want as much of the variable, or as many variables that you can take away from the situation that you can just negate. You want to do that, and training and making sure that you're familiar with your firearm and you know where it is and you know how to clear your garments and you know how your draw is, and the only thing you have to do is fall back on that repetitive training, so that way whatever bad guy has come to hurt you, you can stop them. Be empowered yourself. Don't look to someone else to give you, to give you power, because you're a free individual. You don't need someone else to tell you what you can or can't do. You don't need permission. You're a free, complete individual. So stop asking if you can do stuff. Go out and do it. And, you know, let someone come and try and stop you.